From colorful pills to chewy gummies in the shape of your favorite cartoon characters, there are tons of multivitamin supplements to choose from. And people spend billions of dollars every year trying to boost their health with them. Vitamin and mineral supplements are a $14.3 billion industry in the US alone. And guess everyone knows the three main things you're supposed to do to be healthy. Exercise, eat well, and take your vitamins, right? Well, only two of those things are correct, because we have got decades of data that shows that there's almost no scientific evidence that multivitamins provide any measurable benefit. So today, we are going to examine how multivitamins became a thing, why most people don't even need vitamin supplements, and what you can do to make sure you're getting everything your body needs. Our distant ancestors had primitive game and fruit diet that already provided plenty of these essential nutrients. However, as human civilization grew more complex, our diets began to rely on starchy, less nutritionally dense foods like wheat, corn, and rice because they were easier to grow in large quantities. Industrial processing of these staple foods make them even worse, therefore increasing the risk and frequency of vitamin deficiency-related diseases. Since then, the market for vitamins and health supplements has exploded, and it is currently valued at over $30 billion throughout the world. Countless marketing dollars have been spent to convince us there is a gap in our health that's best filled with a daily regimen of vitamin supplements. But as it turns out, that's not entirely true. In fact, a review of multiple studies that was published in the Annals of Internal Medicine concluded, most supplements do not prevent chronic disease or death. Their use is not even justified and they should be avoided. This message is especially true for the general population with no clear deficiencies, who represent most supplement users in the United States and in other countries. These studies show supplementing with vitamins had no effect in reducing the risk of cancer, heart disease, cognitive decline, or premature death. Actually, an excess buildup of certain vitamins can cause potentially fatal heart and kidney problems. This isn't to say that vitamin supplements are universally a bad thing. If you have been medically diagnosed by a licensed physician as having a vitamin deficiency, you should supplement with vitamins as directed. But guess what? Taking multivitamins to overcome a specific deficiency isn't going to help you, because even if we did have evidence that they are beneficial, which we don't, the multivitamin pills themselves don't actually work. First of all, this industry is not regulated by the FDA. And many of the multivitamins that have undergone independent testing don't even contain the vitamins either in the amounts listed or at all. But here's the kicker, even if they did, their delivery system is entirely flawed. The binders and fillers used to create these pills often prevent your stomach from even absorbing the vitamins. And even if all of those obstacles were overcome, there is absolutely no guarantee that these all-in-one vitamin pills contain a combination that's right for your body. If you are taking multivitamins, you are likely consuming a whole lot of unnecessary stuff that's going to pass straight throughout your system. Basically, you are just pissing your money away. If you are really devoted to getting all your vitamins, the best thing to do is eat a wide range of healthy foods and listen to your doctor if something is lacking. Because science.